when you look at the numbers, he really doesn't deserve to be in thought of as an elite quarterback. And because he's on such a bad team, until the last couple weeks, we really weren't thinking about him much. And if you dug into the numbers, say, yeah, maybe he's not actually, maybe his reputation and the way we feel about him really outstrips his performance. This is the second consecutive week where you look at him and go, how do you play quarterback better than that? That's as well as you can play the position. And when a guy like Deshaun Watson, who you know, because lots of guys give you that feeling, I want him with the game on the line, right? But when a guy like that, who gives you that feeling with his pedigree, starts to put together games like he's put together, especially for a bad team, especially for a team that took a step in the wrong direction and had to get rid of the guy responsible. When he starts doing that, it takes away all the excuses and it solidifies his status as, you always have to say other than Patrick Mahomes. You got to say other than Patrick Mahomes because he's in a different stratosphere. The only guy I've ever seen comparable to Mahomes is Aaron Rodgers in his prime. But we have to say, Stephen A., at this moment, Sean Watson's the second-best quarterback in the AFC.
Well, I'm not going to disagree with you there. What I will say to you is that that's not the story that I walked away focused on. The story that I walked away focused on, Max Kellerman, is that Matt Patricia is somebody that needs to lose his job. He's got to go. When you fire Jim Caldwell, and we talked about this yesterday, Max, so I know you agree. When you talk about Jim Caldwell going 36-28, four seasons in the Detroit Lions organization as its head coach, two times he took them to the postseason, and you get rid of him after a 9-7 season. Mike Greenberg, Greeny, on Get Up this morning, pointed out a very salient fact that I think needs to be echoed. Matt Patricia could win the next 24 games straight and still would have more losses than Jim Caldwell did as head coach of the Detroit Lions. Let's repeat that because that's worth repeating. Matt Patricia could win 24 straight games and still have a worse winning percentage and have more losses than Jim Caldwell did in his 4 years as head coach of the Detroit Lions. But this man still kept his job. You see, when we talk about social justice issues, and we talked about people being in the streets and complaining and going off, it wasn't, as I reiterated this point, and I'm very serious about this, it wasn't just about George Floyd having a knee on his neck for 8 minutes and 46 seconds. It's about the fact that on far too many occasions, particularly in corporate America, Black folks have felt like we've had a knee on our neck for quite some time, figuratively speaking, of course. And when you look at how Jim Caldwell was unceremoniously dismissed and let go, but you see the patience that's exercised for somebody like a Matt Patricia, who may be smart, like Rob Ninkovich said earlier, who was a capable defensive coordinator, a champion as a defensive coordinator, and all of this stuff, but clearly inept as a head coach. And 1 year after another, the level of patience is given to him that just doesn't come our way. That's where problems are created. And when you engage in a meritocracy in its true, purest form, and you hold people accountable for doing their job or lack thereof, then you have a better society because we understand that the rules are fair. And with Matt Patricia, that's not the case. I feel sorry for him and his family. I'm not trying to be disrespectful. I'm not trying to say he doesn't deserve to be a coach in the NFL, but he does not deserve to be a head coach, particularly for these Detroit Lions. They are not a good team. They have talent, but they are not well coached. They haven't been well coached. They were 3-3 before losing four of their last five or so. They got a decent win over Arizona. Their other three victories, I think, came against Jacksonville, the Washington football team, and I forgot what other non-winning team it was. This man has not been impressive, but continues to be employed. He should be gone because he's had ample enough opportunity to prove that he's worthy, and he hasn't done it, Max.
I think there's a larger issue there. I mean, I think Deshaun Watson is the story because Deshaun Watson, like, I agree with you about all this. I thought this going into the game. Deshaun Watson reestablished himself, I think, firmly. If you talk about quarterbacks in football, let's just take the AFC. Other than Mahomes, he's the guy. He's the guy. It's a shame that his team has been mismanaged the way it has been, and they've relied so heavily upon him that he keeps them respectable in spite of bad decisions made about him. But in terms to address the point that you just brought up, it reminds me a little bit of the Panthers in this sense. In both cases, Ron Rivera, not African-American, but considered broadly a minority head coach. If you move on from a head coach that is highly competent and winning, but you feel is not quite good enough to get you to a Super Bowl, or you're looking for more, Rivera was usually, like a lot of times in the playoffs, winning seasons, got to a Super Bowl. But the Panthers looked at him and Cam and said, we think we can do better than that. We're going to tear it down to get even better. And then you bring in a head coach, which is not a minority hire, especially. And in fact, you go backwards. Like, the point is, when you make that decision, you make sure that you're actually, in swinging for the fences, going to move things forward. Otherwise, people will rightly say, what happened? We were pretty good, and now we stink. Same thing with the Lions. The Lions had a head coach who was African-American. Two out of four seasons, made the playoffs, averaged 9 wins a season, thought they could do better, and have done much, much worse. And the fact that it was an African-American head coach let go and a white head coach brought in this league where African-American representation in that position is so low, makes it look even worse.
Well, listen, I'm not disagreeing with any of your points. All I'm saying is that if you're talking to me about Deshaun Watson, I'm down with it. All I'm saying is yesterday ain't some prime example because of who he was going against. The Detroit Lions are the 25th ranked team against the rush, 26th against the pass, 27th in yards allowed, and 30th, the third worst defense in the entire National Football League. Matt Patricia's signature is defense. He's not getting it done, period.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.